Welcome to Romex. Super duper doo. How are you? I'm sure you are amazing. I certainly am, because obviously I've just gotten really puffed. I put in 100% effort for 10 seconds, and this is what that looks like and feels like. Can't talk, can hardly breathe, and I've completely changed every chemical response in my body. I haven't burnt any fat, none, zero. I haven't burnt hardly any calories because I only went for 10 seconds. But now the chemical changes happen. So when I ask this question, why do you exercise? Sadly, most people exercise to burn calories and to burn fat. And I say sadly, because that is a very long, slow process. You have to exercise for a long time to burn calories and to burn fat, if you want to burn a large amount of them. And most people don't have a lot of time to exercise. What I've just done now is 10 seconds, which is a very short amount of time. But what I've done now is I've changed three really important parts or processes in my body. And I'm sharing this with you because I don't want people to waste time. I'll rephrase. Do you want to waste time on long, slow, boring exercise that burns very few calories and very little fat, but people say that it does because that's just what everybody says? If you don't understand how the human body works, there's a phosphate system, a lactate system, an aerobic system. As an exercise professional, as a coach, as anybody that's interested in having a fit, strong human body, that's the alphabet, yeah? That's the fundamentals of how the human body burns up energy, three systems to do that. Now, I've just worked 10 seconds in the phosphate system. And as you would know, that's the only system where you can put in 100% effort. The next system, you can work really hard, but there's a waste product called lactic acid. And I don't like it. It makes me feel sick, makes some people throw up, gives you a burning sensation in your muscles. The 10 seconds of effort that I just put in, apart from the fact that I got really puffed, my body didn't feel like it. And as you can hear now, I'm fully recovered. And this is the beautiful thing about when you get fit and when you get strong, obviously your body changes. You have great hair, great skin, great nails, great posture, strong muscles and bones, strong heart and lungs. You've got an immune system that can fight germs, bugs, viruses and diseases. You have a fast metabolism. You can think more clearly. You're more creative. Life is just better when you're fit and strong. So what is the best way to get fit and strong? And most people say exercise. And the reason I'm sharing now openly, I hate the word exercise, is that unless you're going at 100% effort to get 100% result, what's the point of exercise? It becomes long, it becomes slow and boring if you're in the aerobic system, because you can keep in that system all of your life. That's where we live. Breathe in oxygen, breathe out carbon dioxide, and that the body just can keep doing that forever. I don't ever want to exercise in the lactate system because it hurts. Your muscles are burning. And you'll hear that often. People say that, don't they? Oh, feel the burn, feel the burn. Well, I don't want to feel the burn. It hurts. And I don't want to feel sick. And when you go really hard, you actually feel a bit sick, a bit nauseous. So when you go at 100% effort, it's only 10 seconds. It's the fight and flight system. It's the system that gets you away from the threat or helps you fight the threat. No waste product whatsoever. So you feel good. And when you're really fit, you can recover from that really quickly. So if I was going to do another interval now of 10 seconds, I could go now because my heart rate's back to normal and I could put in 100% effort again. If I go before I've recovered and I can't then put in 100% effort, so what's the point? And when it comes to exercise, and I hate that word because all I want is to be fit and strong. How about you? And this process of exercise, I think we've screwed it up. If you don't understand those three energy systems, I think we've screwed up exercise. Phosphate system, 100% effort, 10 seconds. Go again if you want to when you're fully recovered. So heart rate back to normal and you feel like you could go again at 100%. If you're not at that point, don't go again. So you could do that now, you could do that in half an hour, you could do it in an hour, you could do it 10 times throughout the day. I go for 4 puffs an hour, so I do what I just did now, 4 times every hour. So every 15 minutes, or every time I feel a bit stressed, or every time something's frustrating or fascinating, anytime life is throwing stuff at me, I do 10 seconds of a high intense burst of activity. I'm going to share this again. No fat is burnt at all and not very many calories burnt. But there's three things here that are really exciting. Our base metabolic rate, BMR is the shortening version of that, is how many calories your body needs, my body needs, at rest in a warm room over 24 hours. Would you like to increase that? Now, the beautiful thing about having a faster base metabolic rate is you'll burn more calories, which means if you eat the same, you will get rid of some fat off your body. Or you can eat more to stay the same weight, size, energy level, whatever it is that you want to call it. I don't like to talk about weight. But I want to have a faster base metabolic rate. Now, that comes from having more muscle or maintaining my muscle so I don't lose it as I get older. Now, you can't sprint really hard if you've got weak muscles and bones. When you're weak and frail, to be able to go at 100% effort, that doesn't work. So if you keep your muscles strong, which gives you a faster base metabolic rate, if you can stop your muscles from wasting away as you get older, your body needs more calories to exist. So that's got nothing to do with the number of calories I burn when I'm exercising. That means I've got more muscle. That comes from overloading my muscles and bones. Then, if I want to increase my metabolic rate, which is how many calories I'm burning at the moment, yes, a high intense burst of 10 seconds will increase my metabolic rate for that 10 seconds. That's awesome, but it is only 10 seconds. So what difference does it make? It's the injection to your respiratory quotient that makes the difference. So there's BMR, MR, and RQ. And respiratory quotient simply means, where are the calories coming from that I'm burning at the moment? When you're really fit and when you're really strong, you change your respiratory quotient so that your body wants to conserve the carbohydrate that you're going to be using when you sprint harder, when you lift heavy, because the only energy source for that phosphate system is carbohydrate. Not going to burn any fat there. And that's what I always have a giggle. When I exercise, I don't want to burn any fat and I don't want to burn very many calories. I just want to go at 100% effort because I want to increase my base metabolic rate, the number of calories my body needs at rest for 24 hours. I want to increase my metabolic rate. Yes, that's lovely. But my ultimate is the injection into my RQ, my respiratory quotient, which is the percentage of carbohydrate versus fat. So what happens is if I'm constantly putting my body under threat, if I'm constantly getting puffed, if I'm constantly forcing my body to be overloaded, there's a connection in the brain, in the hormonal system, that says this woman is constantly forcing us to go to 100% effort. We want to conserve the carbohydrate for when she does that. So we're going to save the half a kilo of carbohydrate that she can store in her body, and we're going to use her fat stores while she's resting. So if I put that all in a neat little package, your base metabolic rate is what you burn when you are resting. When you've got more muscle tissue or you maintain your muscle tissue as you get older, your base metabolic rate stays high. But that base metabolic rate, you want the calories that you're burning, whatever. Let's say it's 2,000, 3,000, 5,000 calories a day, depending on your size and your gender and how much muscle you've got. The calories that your body's burning, you want those to be coming from fat stores, not from the stored half a kilo of carbohydrate, because you want to be using that half a kilo of carbohydrate for fight and flight and for fighting and flighting. So what happens is you literally, and you hear me say this regularly, but this is the actual scientific process. Your body turns into a fat burning machine at rest. But a fast fat burning machine, because you've got a fast base metabolic rate, you now need more calories to survive, to live, but the percentage of fat calories is much higher because you're conserving the carbohydrate calories. So every time I sprint for 10 seconds flat out, apart from the fact that I'm completely changing my brain chemistry and I feel amazing and I have dopamine rush, serotonin rush, endorphin rush and brain-derived neurotrophic factor to make me smarter, wiser, more logical, think more clearly, neuroplasticity, neurogenesis, that's what happens to the brain. But those intense bursts of 10 seconds make me really fit and change my respiratory quotient. So I'm going to say this again. I don't want to burn fat when I'm exercising, and I don't want to burn a large number of calories when I'm exercising. And I hate the word exercise for that reason, because that is usually the reason that people exercise. Rowie, I burnt so many calories and I exercise for X amount of time, which means I must have burnt some fat. Yeah, you burnt some fat, but really, really slowly. If you compare the percentage of time that you exercise in a day versus the percentage of time that you are resting or doing nothing in a day, I'm not interested in the burning a large amount of calories while I'm exercising, because it's only a short period of time. And you can't burn a large amount of calories. If you're going at 100% effort, you can only go for 10 seconds. And even if you interval train, and you do half an hour of interval training or an hour of interval training, so sprint, get your breath back, sprint, get your breath back, overall, in a 24-hour period, it's still not that many calories. But if I can increase my metabolic rate in my 24-hour period so that I burn more calories while I'm resting, because I've got more muscle tissue, I've maintained my muscle tissue, and if I can change my respiratory quotient, that's the exciting one for me. I want to be a fast fat-burning machine. How about you? And the only way to do that is to work your body at 100% effort so that after you've stopped, your hormonal system says, save the carbohydrate, burn the fat. Save the carbohydrate, burn the fat. And that's how I want to live my life, as a fast fat burning machine. So you see, I could go again now for 10 seconds because I'm completely recovered. My breath is back to normal, my heart rate's back to resting, and I could go again at 100% effort. And that's the only kind of activity that I want to do. It's the way I live my life, and I'm sharing that with you for a very special reason. I hate the word average, because average by definition is somewhere between the best and the worst, and I don't want to live there. Every other exercise session that isn't at 100% effort is average, because you have to pace yourself. Even a 200 meter sprint has a slight pacing component. The fastest race in the world is 100 meters, and as we know, it's now less than 10 seconds. Those elite athletes are doing it in just under 10 seconds. So us mere mortals, if you put in 100% effort, you're really strong, your muscles and bones are strong, you get really fit, and now your body has a whole heap of chemical changes. And I love to rattle them off because I think we forget the importance of what being fit and strong does. And we seem to focus on the exercise, how many exercises we do and how long we exercise for and how many calories we burn while we're exercising, rather than focusing on the outcome, which is how do I get fit and strong. To get fit, you've got to get puffed. You've got to overload your heart and lungs. To get strong, you've got to overload your muscles. And when you've got a fit, strong body, now you have different chemical processes happening inside your body. And you have better posture because you've got strong bones and muscles. You have a healthy brain because you're pumping those neurotransmitters into your brain that make you feel good. You've got a strong immune system to fight germs, bugs, viruses, and diseases because your immune system is built inside your bones. So if you've got strong bones, you've got a strong immune system. Your digestive system works better. Anytime you feel clogged up or you need to detoxify, get puffed, get sweaty, move your body around and watch the poo come out really quickly. The whole process of the digestive system works so much better when you're fit and strong. So everything works better, and yet we seem to focus on long, slow, boring exercise versus 100% effort exercise. 100% effort, 100% result. 100% lift as heavy as you possibly can, keep going till you can't do anymore, use every single muscle in your body, overload your hormonal system, which is where those human growth hormone chemicals come from. The hormonal system is so underrated, it's bloody amazing. So if you want to be fit and you want to be strong, get puffed to get fit, lift heavy to get strong, do it in the phosphate system, which is the fight and flight system. It's only 10 seconds. Go till you can't do any more. Now, as you saw at the start, I could not even talk. I was so puffed. But when you're really fit, you recover quickly and you recover from everything quickly, whether you're sick or tired or stressed or angry or annoyed, it doesn't matter. If you get puffed, you will feel better. And if you're fit and strong, your life will be better. And the only way to get really fit is to get puffed. And the only way to get really strong is to overload your muscles and bones. So here's to a fast base metabolic rate, more muscle, maintain your muscle. Here's to a fast metabolism, which is burn everything you put into your body really quickly. But most importantly, here's to a faster RQ, to fat burning. So a higher percentage of fat burnt at rest means you're fast metabolism, burn lots of calories at rest that come from fat. and you store the carbohydrate to use when you're exercising. So isn't it awesome that you can exercise short, hard and fast, not burn very many calories, not burn any fat at all, and still be fit and strong and lean and healthy and love your life? And that's what I'm here for every single day. Thank you for coming to Romax. Super duper doo, how are you? I hope you're fit and strong and getting comfortable lifting heavy. Woo!